Greetings. When I was growing up, I accepted holidays without question. Easter was, well, Easter. Christmas was, well, Christmas. But then we would come to this strange holiday I could not understand when I was younger. Washington's birthday observed. It bothered me. No one had explained it to me yet. What did it even mean? Washington's birthday observed. Until one day I asked and someone explained. Washington's birthday observed was not really the day he was born on. It was some other day we chose at our convenience to celebrate his birthday. But it was not really the day he would consider special. Now, imagine a billionaire. He is so rich, he decides to give gifts on the second day after a new moon each year. But no one may open their gift until the last gift has been given. So delivery of the last gift is of critical focus to all. But he's a little eccentric, so he defines a new moon by when he can see it from the front porch of his hunting lodge. In fact, he says he'll only tell the planes to take off when he can see the sliver of the new moon himself. And because of logistics, the gifts will only finish delivery 2 days after the planes lift off. And with delivery of the last gift, every man may unwrap their prize. Each year, the media call him and ask, when will gifting happen this year? Really, they are asking, when will the opening happen? He would reply, I'll head to my hunting lodge in the fall, but no man knows when I'll see the sliver of the new moon. Conjunction will happen Sunday, September 13th, but I do not expect to see the new moon until Tuesday, the 15th. So I would not expect gift delivery to begin until then, and not be finished until the last gift is given Thursday, September 17th. The journalist asked, so that date is firm then, the last gift this year will be given Thursday, September 17th. Hold on there, Charger. I said I'd launch the planes after I see the sliver. In the past, that has been 2 days after conjunction. But this year, conjunction happens to occur on the other side of the globe, my friend. So I have no chance to see the sliver after a half a day, and only slightly more chance after 1.5 days. I may not see it until 2.5 days after conjunction, and then the last gift will be delivered 2 days after that. The journalist added, well, everyone is looking forward to the last gift being given. Can you give me a hint when that will be? I mean, we have a paper to run and a radio program to air. We need something more predictable so we can have a more reliable plan for the days of gifting.
But if you paid attention, I've told you how I know when to send the planes. From there, you'll have to figure it out. Depending on when I see the new moon from my porch, the last gift may be delivered September 17th or on September 18th.
Well, that is just unacceptable. We cannot let you decide at the last moment when gifting begins.
Well, you are not in a real position to force me to start delivering gifts before that.
But it is more convenient if we can control when we make ourselves available to get the gifts.
But it is I who have established the days of gifting, so I get to set the dates.
Well, we will just publish the days that work for us.
You may be disappointed, because I will honor the days of gifting that I have announced the way I have said. I hope most of you can understand the point of this example, this parable. It is not my intention to set a date, but rather to establish a concept, a principle. Go back to God's original description of when the days of Rosh Hashanah were defined to begin and therefore end. I think God may be more interested in His definition for Rosh Hashanah than in Rosh Hashanah observed. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.